What's up, Flockers? This is Crowbar, and today Crowbar is ready to play some more of Yooka-LayLee's Toybox demo. I'm sitting here on the far side of that island with a cave that we ended on last time. Went ahead and crossed it so you guys wouldn't have to watch that. And I was sitting here on the pause menu, and it looks like those spirit-looking weird-ass creatures down at the bottom might be a replacement for Jinjos, which could be fun. But they look quite a bit more interesting than the Jinjos did. Anyway, we're gonna roll on in and see what else we can find in this here demo. So I know we need to go back up top so I can use the platforms to get to that treasure chest that I skipped. So let's go ahead and do that before I forget that chest exists. Oh no. Oh, I almost made it. Ooh. Okay. Boing. Oh, come on. Okay, there we go. Boing. You can get a lot of distance with the hover. That's really cool. I always found, like, the hover in Banjo-Kazooie felt more like a way to make sure you were gonna land where you wanted to land, sort of thing, rather than an actual, like, mode of transportation. Not quite, but that's okay. I suppose I could have just swam under, but I think climbing up the side actually was faster. Definitely feel very, very mobile, which is good. It's probably the most important part of a 3D platformer, is you definitely want to feel like you are in control of all of your movements. Shadow tracking is really good. I don't feel like I'm being asked to make anything ludicrous in terms of jumps. Okay, so is this how I get over there? That is a slide. That is definitely a slide of some sort. So now the question becomes, do I use this vantage point to go get those quills? Yeah, it makes sense to try to do the high ones first, I think. Although it looks like I can climb up that bit of rubble right there, so against my better judgment, we're gonna go ahead and go down. Is there a first person? Doesn't look like there is. I can center the camera, but no first person currently. Okay, so let's see what happens when we slide. Oh, that's adorable. They kind of like slalom when they slide. It's super cute. If this is what the game's gonna look like, I really like the actual environment mapping. It kind of like, it's way more detailed than either Yooka or LayLee, but they don't look alien in it, which is impressive. It is. It's bright and like happy and I like it. No, oh, a little slippy, but so far I like that there's not a ton of terrain that you just can't interact with. It's like, that rock has a ledge on it, and I feel like I can stand on it, and oh hey, look, I can. Rather than just like, no, you're just gonna fall off now. Camera is really finicky, but I imagine I could adjust the sensitivity. I'm just not gonna bother. I'd rather complain about it. Okay, cool. I think that is all the quills in this general area. Up to 45. That's almost half of them. And there's like this huge slide thing over here-ish. Okay, that's not an object. Fell right through that tree. Or maybe you just can't stand on tree leaves. Okay, so let's go that away. Cool. Alright. So we got some swirly guys. We got another cave, it looks like. And a real big slide looking thing. Okay, you can't run up these. Can I, like, I can't actually move Well, I'm crouched, but you can roll up them. Whee! Oh, I missed. Ah, okay. I'm not quite sure if I'm supposed to be sliding down this or climbing up it. But let's go up it, because that's what we decided to do. Oh! Almost there, users. 50 quills accumulated. Oh, you stopped me for that? Oh god! That bum bum has got me.
I think you're supposed to be going down.
Probably? But I'm gonna keep going up anyway. Yeah, you're almost definitely supposed to be going down it. So I got about as far up that as I could. Any quills in the water? Oh yes, there are. I definitely want to be able to swim faster than he is currently swimming. Hopefully that is either something you can upgrade, or something that they have tweaked in the main game. Obviously, swimming is not necessarily supposed to be easy, but comparatively to how he moves on land, it's really sluggish. It has kind of a weird momentum to it that makes it difficult to figure out when you should stop pressing a direction. But it's not abysmal. Definitely had worse swimming controls. And at the very least, it's not a platformer in which hitting the water just kills you. So, always a silver lining. He goes up and down pretty quickly. Yes. I had a diatribe I thought of the other day based off of Sly Cooper, and I cannot remember what I was going to talk about anymore. Sly Cooper is kind of in this vein of game that like doesn't really get made anymore. Which is sad, because I really, really liked Thieves in Time. And I really, really wanted the DLC they talked about. And it's still not out. Oh, cool. Don't know if I was supposed to do that. I think I was, but... What's with the pedals? That's cool. It's pretty. I guess we'll find out. I don't think I can go any further that way. I don't think I can roll up the dark blue. No, you can start to, but you get stopped. Alright, is that... That's not water, that's death. I assume. Is this a... What is this? This is funky. I don't understand. That looks like quills. Good collision work. I can't actually cheat the camera to see what they are. Oh, this must be a... This has got to be a puzzle of some sort. But I don't think I have anything to interact with. Unless it's this thing. Can I move you? No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, maybe it's me? Maybe if I roll through it like a puzzle? Oh no! I have failed! He's very slippy. Okay, no, I'm gonna guess not. Maybe there's something at the top that I can knock down? I don't know. Come back to this. I'm not sure what this is yet. How about over here? What happens when I go... Okay, I'm going... Being blown. Blown by the wind. Cheeky-ass mechanical man. Oh, makes it all hazy. I like that. Okay, get these guys. So I guess the pedals are just there to visually... trip off when you're in a windy area, more so than the fog itself. I don't see any other quills on top. If you jump in, you immediately get blown away. Okay. Looks like we got more in here. Ooh. Okay. I'll go left. Get out, get out. Okay, we got out. That's a slammy switch. Yes, so those things behind the glass back there were definitely more quills. What are we at? 11? We're doing good. I feel like there should be something I can do with that, but I guess it's just there to denote it as important. Yeah. There's an awful lot of green. Obviously, this is just a demo, but having some bit of variance in the green would make it look a little less blindingly bright on the ground. But I imagine that won't be a problem in the main game when you have, like, proper ground textures and stuff like that. I hope it's not a problem in the main game. Okay. Yeah, they look kind of like progress markers. Like, go over here. Because we don't have any other way to denote that to you at the moment. Oh god, balls! Balls! Painful balls! Interesting color on top of the box, but doesn't look like I can actually jump high enough to get on top. So I'm assuming it's just... Oh, they're all green on top. I'm just dumb. There's another switch over there. I am really digging how much it wants you to explore with the hover. Right, at the start, I was just kind of like, I'm going to cheat and do this like this, but it clearly is like, no, you're not cheating. That's how it works. Which lends itself very, very well to the exploratory side of things. What's that one do? Secret door. It's another one of those caves that we went in before. Okay, I don't see anything else up here. I don't see quills over on that wall. But I'm gonna drop down a little before where the door is, because I don't know how hard it's gonna be to turn into it. Oh, it's a little difficult. Hug the wall. Oh, come on. Okay, we got it. What's in this one? They're so cute. I initially kind of thought Laylee was a bit doofy looking with the big red nose, but it fits very well. You're like, oh yeah. Whoa. Particle effects? I'm assuming? Just the particle chamber? What's up? Robots really enjoy particle effects. Called that shit. So we got bubbles. Yeah. Oh, it's a motion blur. Very, very subtle motion blur on him. And we got probably snow or cold. Fire that can't hurt me. Electricity and water mixing. Standing flame. Whatever this is, that's gorgeous. Maybe fireworks or something? Cool. I'm kind of digging these little, like, dev room chambers. It's the kind of thing you might, like, find in-game, but this is still a clever way of doing it. Whee! And then we stop. So we can get out. Okay. So, there was no answer to this strange puzzle thing over this way. But I think I have cleared that side. How am I doing on quills? 74, we're pretty close to the end. Hopefully we'll be able to finish this episode with everything. Oh no! I say as I needlessly go backwards. Whee! There is a plant on the ground. I don't really... It doesn't do anything, it's just pretty at the moment. Okay, so that's the dark blue stuff, so that's definitely a slide down. And we just learned that red things hurt us. So I imagine I'm meant to dodge all of those things. I'm starting to think I was actually meant to climb this tower. And that it's just supposed to be hard, because I don't really know how else we would get up that high. Unless it's this right here. Let's see, that's just a little alcove. Really, really trying not to miss, like, barely hidden quills. Oh god! What have we done?
Oh, you suck.
Oh wait, no. I can do it. I can do it 9 times. Oh, that was a ceiling. I almost hit with my head. Yeah. I am both of them. Thank you very much. Ooh, okay. So there's definitely a chest over here. We're just gonna push us over to the 3/4 mark. And got some more over here, so clearly we're supposed to be here. The only reason I feel like I meant to, like, go up that thing is because, like, it led me across that bridge with notes. And it makes you roll up that thing. So, I don't know. Maybe, I guess I can hover over from here? I could probably hover to that green thing from here, but I don't think that actually helps me any. I got that chest. There's a hovering platform. Yeah, I think I just have to beat it.
Go ahead.
I just needed to jump while still rolling. Sure. Right there, I think.
Just gonna hover over that spot.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to. Not quite. There is fall damage. Aww.
Oh, it's adorable.
That was cute as hell. Okay.
It's so cute.
Let's see if we can. Ooh, hovering sombrero? Okay. So this one I need to make the jump and keep rolling. Okay, and that's why there's. Oh no! It's so slippy! Oh good god. Alright, let's try that again. He has quite a bit of drift on him. But I suppose he is a chameleon, not a tire. Ooh. Okay. No! God, that's hard! And maybe that's a thing? I don't know. There might be a way to do this with a bit more control. Oh. And slide. Okay. Ah, God, I wanted to jump again, but he wasn't fast enough.
Oh.
Yeah, this is tough. By the same token, the only punishment here is that you have to try again. Which is getting annoying. I hope that this is, again, just like a proof of concept kind of thing, because, like, I am by no means bad at platformers. And this is difficult. Like, clearly that little extra bit is meant to be there so that you can turn. Yeah, I just... did I overturn? I don't know. Okay, so you... Okay, oh! Alright, that's some clipping. That'll happen. It's a demo. How are we... 20 minutes? Yeah, okay. I'm alright going a little long. If I can wrap it up on this part. Which I don't really think there's enough to do left for a whole third part. Unless there's a whole area I haven't seen yet. Okay. Well, that's part of the problem right there. You can just stop. I was under the impression that I needed to keep rolling. Ooh. So we can make that jump. You cannot turn on a dime, but that's probably, again, what that little bit of extra stuff is. So I was definitely making this harder than it actually is, but it wasn't communicated to me super well what I was supposed to be doing. There we go. All right, cool. What's that? Oh, looks like we might have found our puzzle piece for the thing below. Roll, ball, roll. Whoop. Okay, but instead of going down, does this go anywhere else? Do I actually have to go up that thing? I mean, that arrow is pointing up, but that stuff looks like the stuff that I can't roll up. Oh, there's a cave over there I haven't gone in yet. Maybe I get a power? I don't know. Alright, let's go do this first. Oh, forgot about fall damage. Fall damage is a thing. Yeah. Okay, come on, ball. Oh, getting this thing up the hill is gonna be real fun. I'm curious. So Banjo-Kazooie had transformations that turned you into, like, specialty objects for a given level, like a walrus or something like that when you wanted to go in cold water. And I've seen a trailer that has Yooka-Laylee turned into, like, a snowplow. So transformations definitely exist. I'm just not quite sure if I need it for this. Can I get this with just me? I definitely want it to be against the wall. Come on. Push the ball. Push the ball! Oh, no.
Wait, can you hit it?
It doesn't seem to be, no. My attack does not actually move it. But I got it more than like halfway up. It's not as pissy of a ball as I expected it to be. It doesn't roll back down immediately. I just gotta be careful not to knock it off like I was doing with myself earlier. Alright. Gimme quills. Alright, so we're 11 off, and I can't think of anything else to do but go look in this cave over here. Can I spring that? Nope, not quite. Okay, we gotta climb up. That is a much more tolerable sound effect than Kazooie's chirps. I'm assuming this roll is equivalent of the Talentrot in the Banjo-Kazooie games, which Kazooie stands on her legs and she moves much faster and can go up slopes, which clearly is part of what Yooka can do as well. But Laylee's little chirps are way less annoying than Kazooie's honks. Oh, does it just take me to the top? That'll do the thing, too. Yeah, that would accomplish the goal. Ooh. What are you? Oh, you're one of the little spirit guys. You're the green one. Do I have to chase you? I do. Don't you laugh at me. Shut up. Can I chase him into the corner? No. Hey, I got you. Gotcha! Freeing us ghost riders. What fun, but in the sandbox there's only one. Okay, so yeah, they're basically the Jinjos, but they're ghosts. I know that the game has something to do with, like, books being stolen? Or something like that, like knowledge being stolen? So...
actual ghost
writer. Yeah, I say ghost writer is pretty funny. I'm pretty down with that pun. I may not even have to go down that slide. Oh, wait. Is there any... That's just this. Well, I'm definitely gonna at the end. But, I meant more for the collection of quills. I like the collectibles are a lot more unified this time, too. It's like, in Banjo-Kazooie you had, like, musical notes and jigsaw pieces and Jinjos and, like, honeycomb pieces were your health. But I like that you collect quills to unlock pages. I feel like that fits a lot better. I can break these boxes. And they stay objects for a second or two before they are fully just like, I'm just a thing now. I can walk on the rubble, that's interesting. But that's also in keeping with the treasure chest from earlier. Doesn't look like there's any quills in any of those. Oh god, that was almost bad. What's over there? Doesn't look like anything. I could probably push that box over there in order to get up this thing, but let me just do this too. Okay, that is a very sensitive seesaw. Doesn't look like I can fall off of it though. Just need it to be in the right position to. Oh god!
Oh,
I can absolutely fall down. Oh Jesus. Okay. Camera had a thing there. It's not on a grid.
Why would it be?
I don't know. I just kind of expected it to be because it's a box and there's a box grid all over the floor.
This shit ain't Tomb Raider.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. As long as it's level, I can just spring up a bit. Rather than fighting the saw.
Can't fight the saw, bro.
There's definitely gonna be something up top. Or not.
There's a green thing.
Is there? Oh yeah, good catch. You're gonna be snippy, you have to be loud enough so that they can hear your snippings. Yeah, it looks like you got a treasure. What's up, kitty? User is too high. Frame pipe dick detected. Terminate artist. Okay. Sweet! Quills quota 100. A binary classic. Come find me to collect your pagey. It's so happy! I'm a page! Boing! Alright, what do you have to tell me? Red thing's bad? To the top of the island. Now you can do all those pleasing geometric shapes and grids. Enjoy it before final game's inferior, highly detailed organic art arrives. The draw distance is quite good.
It is. Such salt. Such vinegar.
Yeah. I really wish there was a first-person camera of some sort. That would be very helpful. Maybe there will be. I'm gonna do this
slide.
Say, am I correct? Yeah, red things hurt. Okay. Oh, yeah. It did. And actually, he's very responsive, which is good, because looking at it before, I was just kind of like, that's a lot of obstacles. Oh, no! There was a thing!
Fucked it up.
I didn't know that was there! I know what that does, though. It's gonna open that door.
You gotta go do the whole thing again.
No, I just gotta go through the cave. Which I am absolutely going to do. I'm sure this is just another dev room, but...
Got the other
one. We're gonna look at it, because we found everything else as far as I can tell. Okay. So yeah, I think there was, like, a landing bit. Can I jump? I can't jump.
I'm really upset.
just gonna take the damage because I'm basically invincible in this. Okay, I can hover. So, question one, is this timed? Is it just a shortcut?
Get in there.
I can't hear any sort of timer. I'm giving it a second to see if it closes. Usually in rare games, if a thing is timed, it will let you immediately trigger it again, rather than waiting it out.
Fine.
Yeah, I'm going to assume that it's fine. It didn't give me a timer or anything like that. Ow. Ow again. Oh no! Oh! Okay. That was cruel. That was a very sharp turn. Get up in there. Get on it. What the crap is this? Oh, it's like it's different floor types. They just don't have textures yet. It's ice. It looks kind of like sand. Oh, it's splashy! I'm surprised that, like, none of them are, like, sinky.
Can you jump on some of them, not on others?
Can jump on that. Can jump on that. That seems, like, normal. Maybe they're, oh, the bubbles are nice. The particle effects are actually, like, quite on point. Yeah, you slide a lot further on that one. So this looks like kind of like deep snow, maybe. Alright. There's no insulting robot to yell at me in this one. Okay, so let's go get the pagey and call this good, I think. Until such time that the actual game is out. Which I think about a month from now. Then watch the pagey open something and I'll have to do that too. Ooh. Uh-oh. Well, fuck. Yeah. I took a shortcut. That's what I did. Greetings, user. I have a secret for you. No, you didn't. Ooh, what was that? Where did you put it? You asshole. Move with L, jump with X. Yeah, I know all that stuff. Well, damn. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is cut here until I find the goddamn button. Or maybe I'll fast forward it or something if that's more amusing to me. Which it usually is.
There's one extra here. We're back. But I don't know enough. That's okay. So there's a map here. There's a big map, which frankly probably is the first thing I've ever heard. But no sign of that. Oh, yeah, that's good. And a deal. So we're just adding. Three times. Something like that. We also probably wouldn't have to take that out. We'd be able to go back. I don't have one. Maybe. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and push this. That's cool. And then. I think it's kind of helpful. We're actually surrounded by brown stuff. And shine. Alright, I don't see anything up here. We're down there. Let's see if we cross the thing. Maybe. Okay. Not sure. Whatever. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, maybe I'm sorry. There's a lot of flat space over there. That could have lowered.
Well.
I think all the difference between the green inside. Okay, this one's a little flat. Just need to make one. Alright then. Unless. I'm gonna carry on here. Let's there any tunnel down here? I'll find it.
And nothing. Okay. Oopsie-daisy. Oh, wait. Oh, did I just luck out? I did. Okay, and we're back, and I found it, very luckily, as I was swimming around before I climbed the big fucking mountain. So let's see what it does. Nuh-uh. What do you mean, go right? I wonder what that did. I hate you. Okay, back again soon.
Let me go over this way. How far that way? He's just gonna do it, just to go this way first. And try to do it later. Did you show me how to do anything like that? Just an arrow. Fuck me. Where do I go? What if it doesn't cover repeat? What do I do? It's a little farther than having earlier, and it still doesn't. It's as far this way as I can go. In a straight line. Normally they show you like a teaser, like it's in this area. Okay, so I guess I'll try and pop. Oh, and somewhere.
Oh hey, maybe it means in the water? Maybe just over here? Yes, it did. It did indeed. Go down. Go down further. This was not here before. It has bones in it. It's creepy. We're back again. I found the thing. It was whatever this is. Actually, I may not even need to fast forward that little bit. There's just another one of you! How is that a secret? Get out of the water! Don't you dare make another button. Greetings, users. Oh no! When real world game releases, look for a pirate ship. To a pirate ship. For a surprise. Ground smash lone rock under a nearby tree to reveal the way. Remember this to find the surprise. Okay. That's fine. That's a little hinty thing, and I won't have to remember because it's on video, so Alright, cool. That is gonna do it. This one's a little long, but I'll be able to cut out probably about, I don't know, 7-8 minutes there in the middle by speeding it up. So yeah, this was a lot of fun. I'm really, really looking forward to this even more so than I was before. I very much enjoy how everything controls and the color and just the feel of the game they've got going so far. It's very cute and fun, a la Banjo, and again, some of the first look stuff I've seen on some other YouTube channels have shown some of the new characters that all look adorable, and it looks like the rare witty humor is still very alive and well at Playtonic, so it's very good to see. But anyway, that is going to do it for me this evening, guys. It has been a lot of fun. If you liked what you saw, hit that like button. If you want to make sure you don't miss when I play the actual game, when it comes out in about a month's time, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Join the Murder of Crows. And I'll see you all real soon. Bye, guys.